Because of COVID restrictions, some civil rights activists are facing financial hardships because they can't travel or hold in-person speaking engagements. Latasha Gibbons explains how the community is now stepping up to help.
And for a lot of activists, that's their income. COVID has exposed it and has exacerbated it.
Loki Mulholland is the son of original freedom writer Joan Trumpar Mulholland. He says some activists on fixed incomes had to turn to local food banks for their Thanksgiving meal.
They're at a point in their lives economically that they don't have the mobility, the flexibility. These are our elders. I mean, we're standing on their shoulders, and they just really can't take the weight anymore.
With the support of other organizations, the Joan Trumpar Mulholland Foundation created the Civil Rights Veterans Relief Fund to raise awareness and financial assistance.
But we just need to make sure we're helping those who fought for freedom and fought for all of us.
Hezekiah Watkins, one of Mississippi's youngest freedom riders, used to travel 12 months out of the year before the pandemic.
In January, February, and March, almost every day.
Watkins says many of his fellow activists have tried to hold virtual speaking engagements, but they have not been as effective.
It's hard to tell, you know, when you have 20 plus kids zooming in on you, or, you know, at the same time, it's hard for you to scan the screen.
And they are doing some Zoom things and like that, but it does don't, you know, quite add up to what it used to be.
Mulholland says within a few short weeks, the CRV Relief Fund has been able to help about a dozen activists with basic necessities, but he says the need is great.
There's thousands upon thousands of civil rights activists, the foot soldiers that are out there.
Ruby Bridges has signed on to be the face of the fund. She was the first Black student to integrate a white school in the South in the 60s when she was just 6 years old. She says this is, quote, something that's long overdue.
Well, if you know a civil rights veteran that is in need, or if you'd like to donate to the fund, just look for this story on 11alive.com.